Hello, it's me, Steven, the Calculator Guy, and today I'm going to show you how to move funds onto your Polygon chain and Polygon wallet straight from your Ethereum wallet using MetaMask and the Polygon bridge. So this way you don't need to use KuCoin at all, it makes it much easier. So once you're at wallet.polygon.technology, you can either click on your Polygon wallet to look at the funds in your Polygon wallet, or you can go to the Polygon bridge. And whatever is in your Ethereum wallet, your Ethereum mainnet MetaMask wallet, for example, I have 0.215 Ethereum. Maybe I'd want to add 0.1 Ethereum to the Polygon chain. You can also choose whatever else you want. I don't think I have anything else in that wallet right now, but let's say you want to do USDC, for example. You might do USDC if I had it, which I don't right now. Okay. Then you would click transfer, continue. You would pay this fee. I'm not going to pay this fee right now because I don't need to do this, but you would continue. There's a process. Eventually that process would finish. You'd have to pay your gas fees. And then after that's done, you can go back to your wallet and you would see it in your Polygon network. That's all. So when you want to withdraw this back to the Ethereum network, I'll show it again, all you have to do is click withdraw. So let's say I sent the Ethereum over here, it would now show up here. I would just click withdraw, and I would be able to withdraw my Ethereum from the Polygon blockchain back to the Ethereum blockchain. That's it. So the Polygon bridge, it's super easy to use. You can buy Matic on Coinbase, send it over to your MetaMask on the ERC20 chain, and then just bridge it over using the Polygon bridge. Very simple. I think you might be able to buy Matic on the ERC20 chain on some swaps as well. So however you want to buy Matic, you can get it, swap it over to the right chain, and you're done. Or you can get USDC on your MetaMask chain and swap it over to, and then bridge it over using the bridge. Okay, so let's look at Guppy really quick. So if you've got into Guppy, when I first talked about it, you're probably very happy because the price skyrocketed. I have since exited my initial position because I'm really interested in getting an SRX node. And so I made enough money off of Guppy so that I can purchase an XRS node. However, I did leave some money, which is all profit at this point. So I'm just letting it compound. So let me walk you through how to compound in a liquidity pool. So what you want to do is whatever it is, whatever you have, let's just refresh to see if that's the right rate. Yeah, just catch it. I always change the gas just because I don't want to miss. So if it's 75, I might do 85. And if it's 1, I'll do 5. Because look, I'm still paying less than a penny. And I do not mind. So that'll go through. And if you want to just get ahead of what you'll need to do, just go to trade. By Fry, and because I'm doing the Guppy Fry pair, I'm actually going to click by Guppy as well. Alright, cool. So I have my Fry. Now I want to swap it to Guppy. So let's just click on this. I just need the address. Copy that address. I understand. There's Guppy. I want to change this to Fry, but you won't be able to fry and fry here. So there it is. Not very much, but that's okay. So let's see, 92, let's do 45. Because remember, you need half of each thing for your liquidity pool. Swap, confirm swap. Again, I always increase the gas. 500,000 is fine, and 5 is fine. Sometimes you'll see two pending, even though they're both done. A way to see if they're done is just to go check your MetaMask. So it's done. Cool. So now that I have half Fry and half Guppy, I can exit out of these, go back here, click Get Guppy Fry Liquidity Pool Token, and then get the Guppy Fry Liquidity Pool Token. So max, perfect. Supply, confirm supply, edit, 500,000, 5, save, confirm, and we'll watch. It should be done soon. Meanwhile, let me just pull up the APY APR calculator really quick to see how the Guppy Fry is going to do. There it is. All right, how are we doing? Transaction's finished. You have to refresh the page. If you wait a few cycles, it'll refresh automatically, but I'll refresh manually. Now we're gonna add. See, I'm adding that liquidity token, confirming. Edit. And that should be fine, but I always speed it up just in case. And again, less than a penny either way, so I do not mind. I have $2 and or 2.7 Matic, which should last me all of the transactions I'll ever need. Okay, it's done. So I've added my $4. So now that will be what I'm getting. That'll be the base rate for what I'm getting my APR on. So you can see this is the lowest APR. However, because I've noticed that Guppy, and Fry have been sort of hyperbolically going up or parabolically going up, I decided that I'm just going to throw it in here. That way I don't suffer any impermanent loss. But man, look at that, 16. Oof. It's really tempting. Might have to jump into that instead. But so right now, you know, if Guppy and Fry continue to go up, then I suffer no impermanent loss. This number will go up and I'll still get this. And at 900, let's just say 900. Yeah, 916. That's what it was. So 916, 834, and I'm compounding. I'm compounding twice a day, but it doesn't really matter. My yearly APY will be 849,000, and my daily will be 2.5. So that's excellent. I'm very happy with that. Good numbers for me. After 30 compounds, I'll be at 1,700. So sweet. Okay, let's now jump. Oh, one more thing. If you are playing with Guppy, you'll see they added a new feature, auto compounding. So if you don't want to compound yourself, you can do the auto compounding Fry. Now this is an APY, not APR. So this is the max you're going to get. You're not going to get those hundreds of thousands of APY that I'm getting in the farms, but you will have to do nothing, and you know you'll get this in a year. So 1,000% roughly 1,000% APY over a year, and it does all the work for you. So it's an option. It's a great place to put your Fry if you want to put your Fry there that you farmed. But I'm just going to keep compounding my pools because to me, the 850,000% APY is too good to pass up. All right, so let's jump to Osmosis. Every day you get your rewards from Osmosis. See, I have my little 3.77 reward. And in order to compound that, you have to go to trade, flip, and then do half of that, which would be 1.85. I want to leave a little over, actually. So 1.8 is fine. And then, is that right? 1.8 plus 1.8 is 3.6. Yeah, sure. You want to leave a little bit over because the currency that you use for fees is Osmo, not Atom. So you always want a little bit of Osmo left over. As always, I speed things up just in case, especially with the Kepler wallet, because I haven't figured out yet how to speed things up after I click approve, because it doesn't show up in Kepler wallet the way it would in MetaMask. So I speed it up a little bit, click approve, usually pretty quick. I like that it shows me my transactions broadcasting. Transaction successful. See? Then I'll go to pools. The pool that I'm in. I will add. What are we at now? 6.25. Oof. I will add or remove liquidity. Max the atom. Add liquidity. Same thing. Approve. And you'll probably remember all the steps from here. You add liquidity, then you click start earning. Perfect, start earning. Max, bond. And again, you can do this once a day. So that is how you compound. I don't know what it was. Oh well. $500,000 is a good gas number. All right, cool. So I'm done. I have increased it, and I am ready to continue my day. All of my compounding's being compounded. But let's just check here. So the APR here is 187. 27, one daily compound. I think I have 4,000 in there. So after 30 compounds, I expect 600 unless Osmo continues to go down at a steady rate. I hope it doesn't. But my compounding APY is still above 500, which is really good for anything that is half atom, which I foresee going up even more. So again, three things we did. We learned how to bridge Polygon, which is pretty simple. Just go to wallet.polygon.technology, click on the Polygon bridge, and then bridge over your whatever. You can also go back to wallet, and if you want to deposit, let's say you want to deposit some USDC into your Polygon bridge, you would just click deposit, and then look, boom, there you go. From your Ethereum wallet to your Polygon wallet. Then we went over Guppy Finance, which again, super, super high risk. But the team seems great. This is a sushi swap copy, so the code is good. There's no back doors for rugs. The worst thing that could happen is the project just falls apart for whatever reason. But right now, it's been picking up a lot of momentum. I like it. The APY is phenomenal, hundreds of thousands of percents. But of course, be safe, do your own research, and look, we got a lucky number here. All right, and then Osmosis. Very quick, compounding once daily. Let's hope Osmo, the coin, goes up. That's all. That's it. Thank you for watching. I do have a Patreon now if you want to join my Patreon. You have access to all of my calculators, all of my charts. I do have a pre-calculator now. I guess I'll just really quickly show you guys what it does so you can see it. Where is it? Here it is. Maybe I'll do a video about my pre-search calculator, but here it is. So pre-search is doing great things right now. I'm excited for the mainnet, but that is not what this video is about. But there is a pre-search calculator. If you don't want to become a Patreon and you still want it, it's okay. Just let me know. Like maybe send me a donation. It could be a dollar and I will give you the calculator. I don't want to price anyone out. So that's it. Thank you for watching and have a wonderful day.